Hi children, hope that all are safe and healthy at home. Today we are going to discuss about other heavenly bodies. Yeah children, there are many small bodies which also move around the sun as asteroids, meteoroids and comets. Let us now discuss about asteroids. Asteroids are small rocky bodies which moves around the sun. Asteroids are mostly found between Mars and Jupiter. This is the area is called as asteroid belt. And also scientists are of the view that asteroids are parts of a planet which exploded many years back. Yeah children, if you see here, while asteroids are far away from the Earth, meteoroids come near to the Earth and tend to drop on it. Sometimes asteroids smash into one other and break into smaller pieces are called meteoroids. Yeah children, let us now discuss about comets. Comets are other heavenly bodies that orbit the sun like asteroids. They are made up of ice and dust, not rock. As comets' orbits take towards the sun, the ice and dust begin to vaporize. That vaporized ice and dust becomes the comet's tail. You can see a comet even when it is very far from the Earth. Yeah children, and also however when we see a meteor, it is in our atmosphere itself. Yeah children, let us now discuss about space rocks. As these space rocks falls towards the Earth, the resistance of the Earth other rocks makes it extremely hot and forms a bright streak of light, which we call as shooting stars. The bright streak is not actually the rock, but the glowing hot air as hot rock zips towards the atmosphere itself. Yeah children, let us now discuss about division mapping of our universe. Yeah children, let me now firstly discuss about solar system, which mainly consists of sun, planets and also satellites, other heavenly bodies. Firstly we will discuss about the sun. Yeah children, the sun is the center of the solar system. It is a huge ball of hot glowing gases. It is the nearest star from us. The sun is the ultimate source of heat and light for the solar system. Let us also now discuss about stars. Stars are made up of gases. These gases burn to give heat and light. Stars are of different sizes children. Some stars together form special patterns in the sky. These patterns are called as constellations. Yeah children, some stars are smaller than the sun and while some other stars are bigger than the sun. Sun is the closest star to the Earth as compared to other stars. Yeah children, let us now discuss about the solar system. The sun, together the eight planets, moons and other heavenly bodies that revolve around the sun form a solar system. Yeah children, you already know that we are going to have eight planets. What are they children? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune. Yeah children, these eight planets that revolve around the sun itself, they are classified into two groups, inner planets and outer planets. Inner planets. Yeah children, Mercury, Venus, Earth and Mars are called inner planets because they are closer to the sun. Yeah children, Mercury is called as Budh, Venus is called as Shukra, Earth is called as Prithvi and Mars is called as Mangal. Yeah children, let us know some more interesting facts about the inner planets. Mercury is the closest to the sun and it is called as the smallest planet in the solar system. It has very little air and it is going to have very hot during the day and very cold during the night, and the period of revolutions are 88 days. There are no moons in Mercury. Let us now discuss about Venus. Though Venus is not closest to the Sun, it is the hottest planet of the solar system, and it is also called as morning and evening star. Dear children, the number of revolutions in Venus is 225 days. Dear children, let us now discuss about Earth, which is the third planet from the Sun, and it is the only planet that we live here, right? And 75% of Earth's surface is covered with water. This is the reason why Earth is called as blue planet. In Earth, we are going to have only one moon, and the period of revolutions are 365 days. In Mars, dear children, we are going to have many set of period of revolutions, right? In the same way, Mars also has 687 period of revolutions, and Mars is going to have two moons. It is covered with the red dust, and so it appears red. That is why it is called as a red planet. Dear children, let us now discuss about outer planets. Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus and Neptune are known as the outer planets due to their location from the Sun. Why? Because these planets are far away from the Sun. This is the reason why these planets are called as outer planets. Here children, Jupiter is called as Brihaspati, Saturn is called as Shani, Uranus is called as Arun, Neptune is called as Varun. Here children, let us know some more facts about the outer planets. Jupiter is a gas giant, the largest planet in our solar system, and this giant planet spins faster than any other planet. This Jupiter is going to have 79 moons, and the period of revolutions are 12 years. And let us now discuss about Saturn. Dear children, it is the second largest planet in the solar system. And if you see this picture, Saturn is going to have the rings. Rings are made up of rocks which surrounds the planets, and they are seven shining rings around the middle of this planet. Yes, children, the number of moons in Saturn are 62, and the period of revolutions are 30 years. Yes, children, let us now discuss about Uranus. It is the third largest planet. It is the first planet that was discovered by telescope. Yes, children, 27 moons are present in Uranus, and period of revolutions are about 84 years. Let us now discuss about Neptune. Neptune is going to have 14 moons, and the period of revolutions are 165 years. It is the fast blowing storms are a feature of this planet. Yes, children, let us now discuss about Moon, children, which is the one of the natural satellite. Yes, children, you know that satellites are heavenly bodies that revolve around the planets, right? The moon is a natural satellite that revolves around the Earth. Yes, children, there is another type of a satellite which is placed around the human beings itself, which is the man-made satellite, which is also called as artificial satellite, called Aryabhatta. Yes, children, as you all know that our Earth has only one satellite, that is moon, that it takes just 27 days, and the moon does not have any conditions which are favorable for our life. It has the mountains, plains and depressions on its surface. Yes, children, the time period between the full moon to the next full moon is slightly longer than 29 days. In many calendars, this period is called as a month. Yes, children, let us now discuss about our artificial satellites, children. Artificial satellites are launched into the space for scientific research, to know the valuable information about the atmosphere. They are also used for sending the messages across the countries and sending signals of television programs and weather forecast. They can give warnings of dangerous storms of disasters also. Yeah, children, let us now discuss about asteroids. Asteroids are small rocky bodies which moves around the sun, and these asteroids are mostly found between Mars and Jupiter, children. There is an area for the asteroid belt. Yeah, children, scientists are of view that asteroids are the part of a planet which explored many years. Yeah, children, let us now discuss about meteoroids. Yeah, children, when these asteroids smash into one other and break into smaller pieces are called meteoroids. While asteroids are far away from the Earth, meteoroids come near to the Earth and tend to drop down it. Yeah, children, let us now discuss about comets or the other heavenly bodies that orbit the sun like asteroids. They are made up of ice and dust, not rock. As the comet's orbit take it towards the sun and the dust begin to vaporize itself. The vaporized ice and dust becomes the comet's tail. Yeah, children, I hope that everyone understood the topic of other heavenly bodies and revision mapping of our universe. Thank you. Have a nice day, children.